This is Italian Football Lover Channel, my friends. Italy Switzerland game has been ended 1-1 draw for European qualifiers. Di Lorenzo scored the goal of Italy and Widmer scored the goal of Switzerland. I want to talk about the tactics and analysis of this game. Let's start with all tactics of this game. Italy played in 4-3-3 formation and Switzerland played in 4-2-3-1 formation. Really, in the beginning of the game, Switzerland played more effectively and they developed more attacks from the left flank with Rodriguez and Vargas. Rodriguez moved higher and wider and Vargas made press on Di Lorenzo. So many times Chiesa caught up higher and really right wing of Italy was so empty. Switzerland found so much empty space on the left, and sometimes this forward player Okafor came close to left and really he opened empty spaces for his teammates, and Bonucci and Acerbi shift across to right to Okafor, and really he made an assist to Widmer in first goal. Widmer moved higher, he took infield and his shot scored the goal out of the Italian box with the assist of Okafor in the first goal. Really, Italy's right wing back was so weak defensively in the first half, but sometimes Italy developed attacks from the left with Emerson moved higher and wider in Italy attacks. Insigne tapped infield, and really Italy's formation turned into 4-4-2 sometimes. Insigne made press on defender Schär and Belotti played close to other central defender Akanji, but sometimes Italy's formation turned into 4-5-1. Chiesa and Insigne dropped deep and came back to wings of the midfield. They made the midfield 5 in the first half generally. And Italy found the goal with Di Lorenzo, and Insigne centered the ball into the penalty area, and Di Lorenzo scored the goal with his headshot in the penalty area. The score was 1-1 with this goal. The first half has been finished 1-1. Really, in the second half, Italian team had the ball more and developed more attacks than Switzerland, but these two teams couldn't find so many clear goal positions all the game, and in the second half there were some substitutions for Switzerland and Italy teams. First substitutions for these teams: Belotti out on the forward and Berardi replaced of him, and Berardi played close to right on the right flank after he got into the pitch. Berardi played here like this, and really Insigne played as a central forward after this substitution. Insigne played here, and Roberto Mancini put Chiesa to the left wing. Chiesa played here like this, and Locatelli out, and Tonali replaced of Locatelli. Tonali played here like this, and first substitution for Switzerland team: left back Rodriguez out and Garcia replaced of him. 20 number left wing back Garcia played here instead of Rodriguez. And really other substitution for Italy on the midfield: Roberto Mancini tried to make stronger midfield, and Barella out and Cristante replaced of him in Italian team. And later other substitution for Switzerland team: Stefan out on the right wing, and Imeri replaced of him, and 16 number Imeri played on the right. And really after these substitutions, Italy played better on the midfield. Tonali moved higher and he participated to Italian attacks. Tonali supported the Italian attacks generally, but really in this game Insigne played so ineffectively, and Chiesa really couldn't make effective movements in the game generally. And Insigne out on the forward, and Raspadori replaced of him in Italian team. Raspadori played here like this, and later Shaqiri and Okafor out in Switzerland team are these substitutions. And Frey got into the pitch and played on the midfield. Frey played here, 4 number Frey with Zakaria. And Freuler started to play instead of Shakiri here. And Vargas, after these substitutions, Vargas played as a central forward, 17 number. And Emery played on the left forward like this. And Sol got into the pitch, he played on the right, 15 number Sol. And last substitution for Switzerland team, Vargas out and Zekiri replaced of him. Zekiri played on the forward, 7 number Zekiri. And really, last substitution for Italian team, Emerson out on the left wing back. And Calabria replaced of him. And Italian team won a penalty kick in the last minutes of the game. Berardi tuck infield, he got into the Switzerland box. And this player, Garcia, caused the penalty, but Jorginho missed the penalty kick. And the game has been finished 1-1 draw. This game played in balance generally. All my analyses and all my comments like this for Italy-Switzerland game. You can subscribe to my channel, watch my videos. Please open up your notification links, notification bells. Thank you very much. See you on my next videos, beautiful people. Bye!